Bark, 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 bark.
Well, that was a wild f***ing ride. Welcome back to the Compendium of Monsters. It's Blink Dog Week. Before we continue, smash that subscribe button and give the goodest dog some pets. It's risking its life for your continued safety. Blink dogs are challenge level 1 quarter, and I certainly have less than a quarter of their courage. These medium fey have an armor class of 13, average hit points of 22, and a speed of 40 feet. Blink dogs have their own unique language, Blink Dog. How original! Guess we all can't be winners. In addition to Blink Dog, Blink Dogs understand Sylvan, but cannot speak it. Despite having two abilities, Blink Dogs have the unique experience of both abilities blended into one, keen hearing and smell versus keen hearing and keen smell. The ability is not more powerful than if the two were separate, so I assume Wizards was trying to save space.
Get on with it!
Sorry. Keen hearing and smell do basically what you'd think. The Blink Dog has advantage on perception checks related to hearing and smell. Blink Dogs have a single bite attack that deals an average of 4 piercing damage. When your expected damage per round is 4 or 5, it's not bad,
but it could be better.
For their other action, Blink Dogs can teleport, and I thought they were Blink Dogs because they open and close their eyes too much. With teleport, the Blink Dog can disappear from wherever it's standing and reappear in an unoccupied space within 40 feet that it can see. The Blink Dog can also choose to make a bite attack before or after using its teleport, which is a wild amount of mobility. I attack you and vanish. Thought you got away? I appear and strike! A Blink Dog's description consists of 2 sentences.
A Blink Dog takes its name from its ability to blink in and out of existence, a talent it uses to aid its attacks and to avoid harm. Blink dogs harbor a long-standing hatred for displacer beasts and attack them on sight.
I understand low effort, but yeesh. You actually have to head over to the Displacer Beast description to get a decent idea why Blink Dogs and Displacer Beasts attack each other on sight. The abridged version? The Seelie Court. But you don't show up here for abridged anything. The f***ing Seelie Court decided to take Displacer Beasts, which are monstrosities native to the Feywild, and breed Displacer Beasts for intelligence, malevolence, and predatory nature. The Seelie Court then used Displacer Beasts to hunt Pegasi, unicorns, and other noble beasts. Of course, the idiots who made a dangerous creation lost control of it, and the displacer beasts were free to breed and murder at will, which caught the attention of the Seelie Court, because when don't your delinquent siblings' dumb decisions affect you? Never. In response to the plague of displacer beasts, the Seelie Court trained fey hunters and blink dogs to counter the threat. If you check their respective challenge levels, blink dogs are 1 quarter and displacer beasts are 3, which is a roundabout way of saying there were massive casualties. Displacer beasts were eventually driven to the edge of the Feywild. Some even escaped onto the material plane because, you know,
of course they did.
DMs, blink dogs are lawful good creatures, and I would find it odd if you ended up running them against your players' characters, but I suppose it's possible. Luckily, running blink dogs is pretty straightforward. With a +5 to stealth, Blink Dogs are clearly an ambusher and will try to initiate a surprise round with its target. If its teleport is available, a Blink Dog will either attack a target and teleport a safe distance away to gain partial or full cover, or teleport to a weaker, fleeing, or injured target to try and eliminate that target. With an intelligence score of 10, Blink Dogs can understand and implement relatively complicated battle plans. They also value their lives and are unlikely to sacrifice themselves in battle unless there is no other choice. Blink Dogs are not going to stay engaged in melee range with plate or chainmail wearing player characters. With a movement speed of 40 feet and their teleport as a fallback, Blink Dogs can easily kite most melee player characters who don't regularly take the ready action. With casters, Blink Dogs have to stay close to inflict disadvantage on spells or other ranged attacks. A great and memorable way to run Blink Dogs is to send your player's characters on a hunt for a displacer beast or two. Blink Dogs are really designed to operate in packs, so it's not unreasonable to think that each player character has a Blink Dog they might bond with. Or at least the characters who can speak Sylvan. Blink Dogs getting killed is sad, so don't plan more than one huge fight where you'll likely see Blink Dog casualties. We love our pets and are angry when they get hurt. Players! If you're going to fight Blink Dogs, there are 2 ways you can go about it. The melee option. You're going to spend a lot of time taking the ready action to attack a Blink Dog that makes an attack against you. Opportunity attacks will not work against teleport, so you're welcome to swing, but it's a waste. Ranged! Blink Dogs are going to attack you and stay close until they take a bunch of damage. You have disadvantage to make ranged attacks against an enemy within 5 feet, so the idea here is to make a ranged attack against a Blink Dog who is attacking another target. This makes it so you don't have to disengage and waste your action instead of dealing damage. It seems counterintuitive because you're exposing yourself to more attacks, but Blink Dogs don't have a lot of health and likely won't throw their lives down to stop you when they could come back with a much bigger force. Of course, you could always make characters not align with the Seelie Court and you could avoid all of this, but where's the fun in that? Anyways, what do you all think of Blink Dogs? Gonna dog pile on me for doing a canine 2 weeks in a row? Let me know in the comments below. A special thank you to my patrons. And thank you all so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please hit that subscribe button, smash that like button, share my video on your Twitter, Facebook, or other social media, and make the leap to become one of my patrons on Patreon. I'll see you all next time.